Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be pleasing and acceptable to you, our rock and our redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
You know, when I was young, one of the really fun part about going to the doctor was that I was allowed to stick my tongue out at him. Stick out, say ah, ah. So that was the only time I could, you know, stick my tongue out at a grown-up. Anyway, it was fun. But supposedly the doctor was able to tell a lot about my health just by looking at my tongue. In the same way, in our second reading, James tells us that we can learn a lot about our spiritual health simply by looking at our tongue. And looking at what comes out of our mouth, we can learn a lot about the true condition of our heart. For example, do you grumble? Do you complain a lot? Diagnosis, you're an unhappy person. So it'd be worth praying about, why am I so unhappy? It's a problem. It's a spiritual problem. My words are giving that away. It's something to pray about. Or do you yell a lot? Diagnosis, you're an angry person. It's not that people make you angry. No, you're an angry person. So it might be worth praying about, why am I so angry? And give that up to the Lord. Or instead, do you encourage people? Do you build them up? Diagnosis, you're a compassionate person. You care a lot about other people. It reveals the state of your heart. Or do you give glory to God for all the good things he's done in your life? Diagnosis, you're a grateful person. And you have a living faith in your Lord Jesus Christ. The eyes may be the window to the soul, but it's been rightly said that our tongue is the window to the heart. And just by looking at what comes out of our mouth, we can see right away, just like an x-ray, both the old Adam and the old Eve live inside us, as well as a new creation that Jesus has formed in us the moment we believed in Jesus Christ. In other words, by our words, we can see both what we might still need work on as disciples of Jesus Christ through further prayer, through the power of the Holy Spirit, as well as how we've already come a long way, how we've already been made new through Jesus Christ. So in our second reading, James tells us that because the tongue is so powerful, it can either burn other people or bless other people, we need a bridle. So because the tongue can burn or bless, it needs a bridle. That's what James chapter 3 is about. But what does that mean? Let's take a look at our second reading. If you open up your bulletin, James chapter 3, verse 2, let's read that. He says, "We all stumble in many ways. If anyone is never at fault in what they say, they are perfect, able to keep their whole body in check also." So, who is the truly spiritual person in this world? James says, it's not the one who goes to church all the time. It's not the one who's got the Bible memorized backwards and forwards. Those are good things. He says, the spiritual person is the one who is able to keep their tongue in check. Why? Because if we keep our tongue in check, he says, that means we can also keep our whole body in check. And it follows from that that we can then keep our whole life in check. In other words, if our words bless people instead of burning them, it follows that our actions and our life and our relationships will also be a blessing to others. And then we can be salt, we can be light, like Jesus was talking about earlier in the Sermon on the Mount. We can have that aroma of Christ about us. So James says, becoming a spiritual man, a spiritual woman of God, all starts right here with the tongue. Where do we begin? We start right here with the tongue. Look at verse 2 again. We all stumble in many ways. If anyone is never at fault in what they say, they are perfect, able to keep their whole body in check also. But you and I know that only God is perfect. Only God can be perfect. Only God never stumbles in what he says. You and I, on the other hand, are human. We still have that old Adam in us, the old Eve living inside us. And so one minute we can be quite spiritual, and we could use our tongue to bless other people, and then the very next minute we can be quite carnal, and we start cursing that same person with the same tongue we were just blessing them a minute ago. Look at verses 9 through 11. With the tongue we praise our Lord and Father, yet with it we also curse human beings who've been made in God's likeness. Out of the same mouth come praise and cursing. My brothers and sisters, this should not be. After all, can both fresh water and salt water flow from the same spring? Well, because you and I are still sinner saints, and we are both a new creation with the old Adam and Eve still living inside us, the answer to that question is yes, it can. Both blessing and cursing can still come from the same Both fresh water and salt water can and do still flow from the same spring. Yet this should not be, James says. He's right. So, as fellow spiritual doctors here in this room, what would be your diagnosis for me? If both blessing and cursing are coming from my mouth, and both fresh water and salt water are flowing from this spring, what would your diagnosis be for me? Diagnosis? I'm in desperate need of a bridle, right? And that bridle is called self-control. But the self-control is not something that I can just muster up myself or sheer willpower or just trying harder. No, my spiritual sickness is far too deep for that. Look at verses 3 through 4. When we put bits into the mouths of horses to make them obey us, we can turn around the whole animal. Or take ships as an example. Although they are so large and are driven by strong winds, they are steered by a very small rudder, wherever the pilot wants to go. See, that is what we need. A small bit in the mouth of the horse can move the whole animal, and a small rudder can move an entire ship. That's what we need. We need a bit, a bridle, a rudder for us. Self-control. Easy peasy, right? Look at verses 5 through 8. So also, he writes, the tongue is a small part of the body, but it makes such great boasts. Consider what a great forest is set on fire by such a small spark. There's the burn, isn't it? The tongue also is a fire, a world of evil among the parts of the body. It corrupts the whole body, sets the whole course of one's life on fire, and is itself set on fire by hell. Who here has ever gotten in trouble or made a bad situation even worse because you couldn't control the tongue? Guilty, right? He goes on, verse 7. All kinds of animals, and birds, and reptiles, and sea creatures are being tamed and have been tamed by mankind, yet no human being can tame the tongue. It is a restless evil, full of deadly poison. So, diagnosis. Yes, I do need a bridle. I do need self-control so that blessing can come out of my mouth and not cursing. Fresh water can come out and not salt water. But verse 8 says that no human being can tame the tongue. No human being. So who is the only one who can tame the human tongue? The only one who can tame the human tongue is the one who created the human tongue. Our good and gracious God in heaven. Our Father in heaven who loved you and created you. Our Lord Jesus Christ who died for you and rose again for you. Our Comforter and Counselor, the Holy Spirit, who now lives inside you and gives you the faith and the power to live a new life as a new creation. So here in James chapter 3, we're confronted with the harsh reality that you and I cannot be spiritual. You and I cannot be a spiritual man or a spiritual woman without the power of the Holy Spirit coursing through us. Because what is the fruit of the Holy Spirit for those who live daily walking Spirit. Let's go through those together. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. There it is. The very last fruit we just mentioned. The self-control is something the Holy Spirit can create inside us. We can't muster that up ourselves. So diagnosis, we do need a bridle, we do need self-control so that blessing comes out of our mouth and not cursing. And then we can keep our tongue in check, and then it's easier to keep the rest of our body in check, and then our whole life can become a blessing to others rather than a burning of others. That's the diagnosis. We need a bridle. But what's the prescription? Pray. Pray, pray, pray. Because a bridle of spiritual proportions is only going to come about through spiritual means. We can't come up with that ourselves. So we pray to be filled with the Holy Spirit. We pray to be led by the Holy Spirit. We pray that the Holy Spirit would give you love, give you discernment, and give you self-control. So then we can think before we speak. And we can ask ourselves these three basic questions before anything ever leaves our mouths. Is it true? Is it kind? And is it necessary? Those are called the three gates of speech. Is it true? Is it necessary? Is it kind? Because there's absolutely no virtue to speaking our mind if we've got something to say. That's how we end up burning people, right? We speak our minds without thinking about the consequences. We don't think about how our words have effect on people and can hurt people and cut down and destroy people at times. But if we could ask the Holy Spirit to help us hold off speaking our mind until we've asked those three questions, is it true? Is it kind? Is it necessary? That instead of using our tongue to burn people, we can now use our tongue instead to bless people as disciples of Jesus Christ are called to. So diagnosis, we need a bridle. Prescription, daily prayer, and daily trust in the power of the Holy Spirit. Prognosis, that both prayer and the Holy Spirit in your life, your chances of spiritual recovery and healing are excellent. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, forgive us for trying to live the Christian life without you. Forgive us for trying to be spiritual without the Holy Spirit. It seems silly. We phrase it in these words, but that's what we try to do. We try to have spirituality without the Holy Spirit, and it just doesn't work. We pray, Father, for forgiveness for the ways and the times that we've used our tongue to cut down others and to slice down and destroy other people. When you gave us this tongue to bless people with, to build other people up with, to encourage and to uplift, to bless. And our sinful nature finds other uses for it. I pray, Holy Spirit, that you give us the gift of self-control. Help us to think before we speak. Help us to think about the effects and consequences of our words. Help us to ask ourselves, is it true? Is it kind? Is it necessary? Is it a blessing? And I pray, Father, you would help us to use our words to lift another person up this week. Help us to bless and not burn. We pray these things in Jesus' powerful name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.